It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Hey there, Eagles. Welcome to school for the week of November 30th. We hope you had a fabulous Thanksgiving break.
Let's turn to Ms. Christensen's class for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thanks, Ms. Christian's class. Job well done. Let's see what's happening at Armstrong this week.
It's good to get back into the normal schedule. Tomorrow begins the open enrollment window for the 2015 through 2016 school year. Let's turn to Mr. Howe to learn more about that.
Hey there, Eagles and parents. We are at a significant date in the school year, and those of you who have participated in this year's past know just how significant it is. The state of Utah has an open enrollment law that allows for people who don't live in a school boundary to turn in an application to attend a school outside their own neighborhood, and that opens on December 1st. That's tomorrow. It actually opens up at midnight tonight, which is the first time we actually get to December 1st or tomorrow. We do that on our webpage. It's a first come, first serve basis. So this is for anyone who does not currently attend the school. If you have younger brothers and sisters who are planning to come, they would apply to them. They would need to turn in an application if they want to start coming next year to Neil Armstrong Academy. It does not pertain to any of the kids currently attending the school. And it also doesn't pertain to any of the kids who live inside our school boundaries. And you can see those boundaries on our school website. So once again, the open enrollment window for all of Utah, including Neil Armstrong Academy, opens tonight at midnight. And applications can be received by schools for next school year. That's the 2016-2017 school year. And they are done on a first-come, first-served basis for those who do not live in the boundaries and who are not currently attending the school. Have fun.
Thanks, Mr. Howe. We appreciate those details. Let's find out what kind of weather we can expect this week at the Armstrong Weather Porch.
Thanksgiving is a great time to reflect on what you're grateful for. Let's see what the Armstrong Eagles are grateful for.
What are some things you are thankful for?
I am grateful for my family and my dog.
Good friend and for my family.
Well, my family, of course.
For my family and going to the school.
My family and my education.
My family.
I'm grateful for the education here at Neil Armstrong.
A show.
Family.
For Thanksgiving, Christmas, and food.
Potatoes.
Family.
Food.
What are some things you're thankful for?
School.
Math.
Sports.
This week, I'm thankful for family coming together for the holidays and all the good food and all the good football on TV.
I'm thankful, and I'm thankful for the school.
I'm thankful for my friends and family.
I'm thankful for all the technology we have here.
Me! I'm thankful for Neil Armstrong Academy.
My family.
iPads.
I am thankful for my awesome family, and I am thankful for the awesome school where I get to teach and the cool students and teachers who work with me.
School.
My Nana.
My pet cat.
My cat.
I'm grateful for school.
My principal.
God.
Summer break.
My family.
Home.
Everything.
My family.
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 Thanks so much for sharing. We love hearing about those things. Even on a short week, we've got a wheelie whip around to share.
Awesome stuff. Thanks for sharing, Eagles.
At the November meeting of the Armstrong Academy Community Council, an addendum was proposed for the current land trust plan for the school. The addendum includes using land trust funds to hire additional paraeducators to facilitate the reading program for kindergarten, first, and second grades. They will help monitor each week students' reading abilities and allow certified teachers to devote extra time to intervention with students who are not reading on grade level. iPads will also be purchased to help with the reading efforts of the students. The addendum also calls for hiring substitute teachers to allow regular teachers near daily collaboration and professional development time to, among other things, address student learning outcomes and data analysis. Two on-site facilitators and a visiting professor from BYU will assist in the professional development for Armstrong teachers. Following any feedback from the parents, the community council was scheduled for formally vote to approve the addendum to the land trust plan after the summary for ABC News was recorded. Armstrong Academy is pushing forward with its application to receive an official state designation as a STEM school in Utah. The school will pursue Platinum, the highest level of STEM designation, which requires at least 100 points in a number of categories regarding educational programs and performance. Armstrong will submit its STEM designation application by the deadline in February. The issue of donation and fundraising efforts at Armstrong Academy was discussed, namely creating better coordinating among official school-wide fundraising and individual voluntary classroom donations, requests for such things as classroom supplies. The issue was discussed with the school's leadership team to get the teacher input to develop a more streamlined process to keep fundraising and donations requested within reason and within Granite School District policy. The Community Council's next meeting is on December 10th. As always, parents and the public are welcome to attend. Thanks for listening.
Finally, let's get a check in on the reading blast off.
I read the Beyonder series. I like this series because there's a lot of fighting and adventures. You should read the series if you like adventures and action.
I read the Diary of Wimpy Kids series, and you should read this series because it has really funny events and it is hilarious. One reason, in one of the books, the ninth book, they go on a trip and in their car, and it takes them really long to get back. So you should read this series because it's awesome.
I read the Wings of Fire series. I liked the series because it was full of fun, adventure, and dragons. There are 7 types of dragons: mud wings, sea wings, rain wings, night wings, ice wings, and sand wings. There are a few main characters: Clay, a mud wing; Tsunami, a sea wing; Glory, a rain wing; Sunny, a sand wing; Starflight, a night wing. And that's really all the main characters.
Awesome stuff, readers. Thanks for sharing.
That is it for us. Thanks for watching.
This is ABC News.